Michael Keaton, one of your amazing ensemble cast. How did you get him on board?
The simple answer is we offered him the part and he said yes. You know, that's what happened. I never thought he would do it because he hadn't done TV in 15 years, since he's resurfaced as this sort of leading, one of the great dramatic actors. And he also was an ensemble show. He's not the lead, there is no lead. Although he's kind of the main character, but it's an ensemble. And I thought, well, Michael Keaton's gonna, first time he's gonna do television, he's gonna be in an ensemble. But it was our first, we hadn't offered any roles to anyone. So when you're making offers to actors, if you've been greenlit and you're making offers to actors, you don't wanna get too many passes. Because if you start racking up a lot of passes, the people that are financing it, they start to get nervous. Like, oh, talent doesn't want to do this? Is there something wrong with this? So someone like Michael Keaton, I would only make that kind of offer maybe twice. And then I'd get scared and then go to a tier of actor that's not as famous and as in demand as him. Or unless I would talk it out with Hulu and say, I don't want to get any more passes. And they'd say, we don't care about that. Just make one, you know, that, like you can have that conversation, right? But then I wouldn't fully believe them. I'd be like, yeah, but you get that third pass and are they going to start freaking out? So, but it was the first offer. So it was like, okay, let's just try it. And then he wanted to meet with me, which was amazing for me because he's another childhood hero. I grew up on his comedies when I was a kid. And he was literally one of my favorite actors. It was Michael Keaton and Jack Nicholson were my two favorite actors when I was 8 years old. Same height as I am now. It's crazy. But and so it was just, yeah. So it was really thrilling, A, just to meet with him, and then B, and then he said yes.
And he actually has a personal connection to this
boy. Yeah, which I didn't know, which is his nephew passed away from a fentanyl overdose. So this story was really personal to him. So... I'll tell you this because he's already said this publicly, but I met with him and it went good. He didn't say yes in the phone call, but he was clearly interested. And then I got a call that he wants a document of his arc for the rest of the season. So I wrote a 5-page document of what happens to the character. And then I sent it off, and then a week later, he said he was in. Great. So then he gets episode 4, which is a very big turn for the character that wildly affects the rest of the season. And he called me and he said, this is crazy. I what? And I said, Michael, it's in the document. He said, well, I didn't read it. now he's like, this is going to be a lot of work. and I said, yeah, but it's going to be great. It's going to be great. And he's like, okay. You know? Yeah. So anyways, so that's how we got Michael Keaton. So, but in, now at this point, right, I've got this show. It's been greenlit. I've got Barry Levinson, legend, Michael Keaton, legend. Like, now we're good. You know, all that tension of, you know, then we were off to the races and then everyone wants to be in the show now. So it's awesome because it doesn't always go that way, you know? Doesn't always go that way.